My name is Brett Example, and I am joined by
Miss Moxie. Hey, everybody out there in WFTDA.TV Landia.
We are gearing up here for the second bout of the day, the Arizona Roller Derby All-Stars, the Tent City Terrors, taking on the Sacrificers of the Sacred City Derby Girls. These teams have only met once before, and at that bout, Sacred City was victorious, taking the first star of the day for Arizona's number 43, Sybil War.
And that is number 53, Daddy's Girl, a brand new back to Sacred after about a year and a half off. I bet they're happy to have her back, Brad.
The winner of this bout advances to face the Denver Roller Dolls tonight. Denver is the second seed in this tournament, so that's going to be an uphill climb for whichever team does win this. But first things first, 30 minutes on the clock.
Somebody's got to win this game. Arizona coming into this bout seeded number 7, and Sacred at the bottom of the heap, ranked number 10. It is a scrum start here.
But pushing around the outside, it looks like the lead jammer is going to be Sybil War for Arizona.
That's Daddy's Girl for Sacred City in the gray and burgundy.
You are absolutely right.
She's going to pick up lead jammer. She is scoring some points there. Got just about two more left to pass.
Strong defense at the front of the pack by Sacred. Sybil War is pushed to the outfield. She has to come back in behind that four wall, but Daddy's Girl now finds her way through on the inside. That's the first points of the game, grand slam for Sacred City.
And as we saw in that last game, Angel City versus Wasatch, grand slams and power jams specifically really make a difference in this game that we're playing.
If you did not see that last game, I definitely recommend checking it out on the archives later. It was a hard-fought bout, but finally, Angel City did win by 10 points. We have an injury on the track.
It looks like while Daddy's Girl was propelling herself forward on the track, she was falling and got called on a high block because she was blocking with her head, apparently.
But it fortunately didn't take her long to get back onto her skates and off the track, so it doesn't seem to be a serious injury. Glad to see that. We're down to 28 and a half minutes in the game. Second jam. Looks like
that's Loco Lena on the line for the Tent City Terrors. It's going to be a power jam for Arizona.
Because Daddy's Girl sitting in the box.
She's sitting for a minute to think about what she done. And clearly, it was not intentional. She's actually motioning to her team right now. What did I do? But, you know, if you make contact with your head, intentional or not, the refs are going to call it.
Exactly. And the clock is still stopped, though, from that injury call. So 28 minutes and 20 seconds in the first period.
And we see some Tent City Terrors fans there in the pink and black. And there's some Sacred City fans there in burgundy and pink. These teams have very similar colors, but their uniforms, thankfully, are very, very different.
So we have been warned. There's an interesting phenomenon here. We've got a high-speed internet connection across the bay, but apparently if a ship comes through at just the right time, or I should say just the wrong time, it will interrupt the internet. So if we do disappear suddenly, it may not be our fault. So we cannot go out there and steer the ship, so I'll warn you about that in advance. In the meantime, you can talk to us with the Twitter hashtag #TalkNumeral2WFTDA.
Those are some big ships out there in the bay, too. There's no way I could steer one of those things. I'd need like 5 tugboats. Still a bit of a time out there on the track.
Looks interesting like circumstance there. Because that prior jam was not called off by the jammer, but was called because of the apparent injury, that means that Daddy's Girl cannot skate again right away. So she's been replaced in the penalty box by Sacred City's number 44, four closer.
A worthy replacement.
Definitely.
I do say so myself.
Four closer has been a long time heavy contributor to the success of the Sacred City Derby Girls. Next jam is underway. And Loco Lena out there with the star trying, pushing on the outside. She gets around the outside, but she's not going to get called lead. Minor cutting penalty.
Number 22, Slapjack, out there kind of directing the Sacred Pack, telling everybody where to go and what to do.
So Arizona does have the ability to score, though, and Lokolina is in the pack now, trying to find her way through, having some trouble on the inside line, but there she completes, and 5 points. That's going to tie up the score.
Looks like Sacred Pivot cash money going to the box for
as Sacred. Is number 57 for Arizona, which is Messy Missy. So the packs, and now that's number zero, which is Kiki Uraz for Arizona. Penalty box filling up rapidly in only the second jam.
And once again, Slapjack, number 22, steering the ship, that is the Sacred City pack, for closer, out of the box.
But looks like Lokolina did manage to pick up 5 more points, and Forecloser doesn't make it into the pack in time, even though she was unopposed on the track.
Yes, and she was given lead on her initial pass there.
So, with just under 27 minutes, that takes the score to 10 to Arizona, 5 for Sacred.
Those are some nice numbers to work with, 10 and 5.
Yes, indeed.
Easily divisible. I'm not good at math, but...
That's Jam and Jules out there for Sacred City, and number 2012, Maria Montoya for the Arizona 10th City Terrors.
And we've got a micro pack. It looks like just 2 and 2.
I agree. It's a pretty cozy little situation out there.
Very interesting. And looks... Oh, my gosh, Brad, do we have a pivot line start?
It looks like... Yeah, that's where all of the blockers are right now. The jam clock is ticking, so they started at the jam, but neither team had taken a knee. So we actually are 30 seconds into the jam before the jammers start skating, but there they go.
There they go. And right there on the inside, Jam and Jules is going to get lead jammer for Sacred.
But not far behind is Maria Montoya.
I'd say she's got just over a quarter lap. Sacred blockers out there working to make some points there for Jules.
The pack is filling up again as skaters re-enter from the penalty box, but that's a 2-point gain for the lead jammer, Janiman Jules.
Making it 7 Sacred, 10 Arizona. I got my scores switched, and I will admit I am horrible at math. I'm sorry, Brad. I'm going to fail you multiple times today.
Not at all. It will be awesome. Taking the star in her own right this time for Sacred City is number 44, Forecloser, facing number 924, Loose Chaos, for the Arizona 10th City Terrors.
And we've got nobody in the box. Full pack for both teams. Hooray. I raise my water to that.
Forecloser pushing at the front behind a 3-wall of Arizona. Not having much luck right now. Getting some offensive blocking assistance.
Forecloser really has a tendency to want to push through on her own. And she usually does a pretty good job of it. She's a very strong skater. She's been doing figure skating and speed skating since she was a young lass.
Loose Chaos got launched into the outfield for Arizona, had to come back behind the pack. We do have a lead jammer declaration. And that's for Loose Chaos. She's lead jammer. Forecloser is out of the pack in front of her, though.
Just about half a lap till she hits that pack. I wonder if Loose Chaos knows she's lead jammer.
Well,
the crowd is yelling at her to call it. I don't think she's aware.
Loose Chaos is pushed into the outfield. Her ref is pointing. She's heard the whistle. And so Forecloser manages to pick up a grand slam. And now Loose Chaos does know she's lead jammer, clearly, because she calls off the jam.
Sometimes you just gotta learn from your mistakes. We got 12 for Sacred and 10 for Arizona.
So we want to thank our sponsors, of course, for WFTDA.tv, starting off with Derby Skins. That's derbyskins.com with a Z. They are the original Shiny Heine. Maybe imitated, but never duplicated.
I've seen several Shiny Heinies out here.
It seems to be a trend in this crowd.
Roller girls do like their shiny. That looks like number 45, Colt 45, jamming for Sacred right up the inside. She's going to be lead jam.
And number 43, jamming Sybil War for Arizona. A repeat of the first jammer for their team. But lead to Colt 45.
And Sacred blockers doing a pretty good job there of holding off that Arizona jammer until their jammer comes through.
There goes Civil War right now, but 4 points for Sacred before, just as the jam is called off.
A little bit of back and forth here in the beginning of this game. You know, it's only noon, Brad, but these girls got here at about 8 o'clock this morning, were ready to go, have had their coffee or their Red Bull or whatever they're drinking, and, man, they're ready to go.
So far, looks like for Arizona, the leading scorer is Lokolina with all 10 of their points. It's been divided more evenly among the Sacred City jammers.
And she is jamming again right now for Arizona. Daddy's Girl back on the track after her three jams off injured. She is stuck there in the back behind a wall of Arizona blockers.
And Lokolina picks up lead, but she's pushed to the outfield by Slapjack. But now Slapjack called for a penalty.
Probably an out-of-play call if I had to guess. And Arizona in scoring position. Daddy's Girl still trying to make her way through the pack on her initial pass.
All four Arizona blockers are out there, but Daddy's Girl goes to the outside and does break that pack. Lokolina trying to complete the scoring pass. She does. Will she call it? Yes, she will.
And it looks like going to be 4-0 there for the Tent City Terrors.
Closing the score to only a three-point gap, 17-14 in favor of the Sacred City Derby Girls, and the clock ticking down to about 21 minutes.
Brad, you know, the Arizona Tent City Terrors are one of Wicked Skatewear's sponsored leagues. Wicked Skatewear hearts their sponsored leagues, Denver, Bay Area, Arizona, and Angel City.
We'll be seeing all of those teams playing today. Number 2012 has the star for Arizona. That's Maria Montoya for the second time in this period.
And number 209, Jammin' Jules, is trying to hoping to recreate that quick lead jam she got earlier in this game.
Knee start for Arizona. Only two blockers out there for Sacred, so 4-2 advantage for the Tent City Terrors.
And if I had two blockers on Sacred to pick, I would pick 23 Axle Breaker and Cash Money. They're two excellent blockers.
I believe that's number 425, Misbehaved for
that
Sacred.
That is Misbehaved. They both have that blonde ponytail.
Ah. Looks like both of these teams continuing a bit of a trend. A lot of teams do not have their names on their jerseys. I think it's completely to make the life more difficult for announcers.
Of course.
Remember, we do have a Twitter hashtag where you can talk to us. It is talk, numeral 2, WFTDA. Jam underway. Montoya is at the front. Jammin' Jules held up at the back behind a four wall.
And even with just two Sacred blockers out there, Jules is going to pick up that lead jammer nod. Nice work.
Only one to beat now. That's Axel Breaker holding on to Montoya.
Nice.
Doing so very successfully.
Axel Breaker, the sister of number 22 Slapjack. As I said earlier, they both grew up on skates, so very comfortable in this game.
Gavin Jules makes her way through that pack. It's a grand slam for Sacred. Back into the pack for points again. Montoya pushing, but now facing a much stronger wall of Sacred blockers as the penalty box has emptied out.
And Jammin' Jules says, you know what? I saw that jammer get out. I'm going to take my points and go home.
And so Montoya had managed to get out of the pack, but looks like a couple more points for Sacred City, taking the score to 24 for them, 14 for Arizona, and we're about 19 and a half minutes in the first period.
Fun fact about number 44, the forecloser jamming for Sacred City. Her name comes from the fact that she's a real estate agent.
Very appropriate. Loose Chaos, number 924, has the star for the Arizona Tent City Terrors.
Loose Chaos looked like was trying to make her way through with her head.
Oh, nicely done on the inside lead jammer, Arizona, but forecloser not far behind.
And if I know forecloser, she's going to want to make her call it off. Let's see.
In fact, forecloser smack dab on the heels of Loose Chaos. But Luzquez does get into the pack. She wants some points. And now only a couple of Arizona blockers to beat from the floor. Luzquez calls it off. 3-2 score in favor of Arizona.
That's hard work for three points.
Well, in fact, hard work for a net gain of 1 point.
Yes, yes. It's all about the differential here in roller derby.
Colt 45 returning to the track for Sacred City, along with Kiki Uraz for Arizona.
Her zero looks real crazy. From here, it looks like a square on the back of her her jersey.
Well, as a computer guy, I appreciate the slash through the zero, because then you don't think it's a letter O.
Oh, gotcha. So,
and she wasted no time getting through that pack and taking lead.
Serious business. Kiki put on her focus pants this morning.
She's back into the pack. 4 points as they head into turn three.
And I hear whistles. Somebody's going to the box.
Oh,
and it looks like we had a major track cut there for the Sacred Jammer. Colt 45 is going to sit for a minute. And I'm not sure if Kiki saw that.
I think, but Kiki did call it off, so we're going to start in a power jam for, in this case, 5150, which is Loco Lina for Arizona. Just over 17 minutes on the clock. And score standing at 26 for Sacred, and Arizona's closed it to 20 points. So only 6 points between the two teams.
It looks like Arizona's got the jammer advantage, but Sacred does have four blockers on the floor to only three for Arizona. So,
nevertheless, Arizona took the knee to start the jam right away. They want their jammer to have the maximum amount of time out there. But push to the infield and coming back behind.
Nice move by Neil and Weep there on Sacred. She does it again, feeding that jammer to the outside.
First to the inside, then to the outside. But now, finally, Lokolina through for lead.
And it looks like a major forearm is going to a Sacred blocker. I can't quite tell who that is.
That's number 67.
Rose Villain is going to sit for a minute right next to her teammate.
Lokolina taking advantage. 5 points. And that's going to take it to a 1 point game.
Something tells me she's going to want to push that so that we have a lead change here.
Track, the pack is pretty much stopped in turn three. Oh, and it's going to be a backwalk major call for Lokolina, just as
Colt 45,
45 came
out of the
back
box.
On the track anyway. So that wasn't the jammer do-si-do there.
And some nice juking there by Colt gets her out of the pack. She's not lead jammer, but she does still have a little bit of time to score.
And that's unopposed time. Four wall of Arizona blockers at the pretty much at the pivot line, but she's throwing. And there's five.
You know, Brad, watching Colt 45 jam, I see a little bit of Bonnie Thunder style in her.
Really?
She does that shoulder juke thing where she gets side to side.
Yeah, fairly similar build, actually, to Bonnie Thunders. But still some very strong blocking up there by Sybil Rohr and by, is that Whoopsie, number 60?
One more grand slam there for Colt 45, making it 36 Sacred, 25 Arizona, just as we hear the whistle for that jam. 15 minutes left in this first half.
That was number 57, actually, Messy Missy, teaming up with Sybil Rohr to do some excellent blocking at the front of the pack. And score after that jam, 36 for Sacred City, 25 for Arizona.
I'm going to give a shout out to Rollerbones and Bones Bearings. They are always a winning combination, kind of like you and me, Brad. We're a winning combination.
I agree, Moxie.
We have got a power jam with the four closer jamming for Sacred City.
But Lokolina is standing in the penalty box, so it won't take her long to get back on the track.
Lead jammer picked up by the four closer.
In fact, ooh, through the pack. That's going to be five for Sacred.
Nice little hop, skip, and a jump there by Forecloser.
Lokolina trying hard, but still held up in the Sacred pack.
They've got her on the inside. They're taking her to the outside. They're really dictating. Sacred's pack is really dictating where Lokolina is going at this point. And we have a major out of play there by an Arizona blocker. Meanwhile, back at the ranch, the foreclosers picking up a grand slam. And the jammer for Arizona is in the box.
Look, Alina, that's her second jam, actually, when she's headed to the penalty box. So another power jam, two in a row there for Sacred.
The foreclosers like, okay, let me see what I can do here. And we've got, I think, a high block there by the Arizona pivot. And one more grand slam for the foreclosers.
This is really opening the gap here for Sacred.
Nice duck around the outside. It's going to make this a 15-point jam so far for the foreclosure and Sacred City.
Actually, I think this has been 25 so far.
25. Like I said, Brad, bad at math. Thank you for being here. What would I do without you?
But so a huge jam and five more at the end. That takes the score to 66 for Sacred City, 25 for Arizona, 30-point jam for the foreclosure.
Sacred definitely can use that. As we know, though, Brad, you can't get too comfortable, even with a 30-point lead, even with a 50-point lead.
Oh, man, in that first game today, Wasatch scored something like 40 or 50 unopposed points against Angel City and almost took the lead.
They almost did it. They almost came back.
Jammin' Jules with the star out there for Sacred City and Kiki Uraz for Arizona.
And we had a jam start, but not a jammer start. There we go. There's that double whistle.
Once all those blockers get too far away from the vivid line.
And we're off to the races. Jammin' Jules is out front. She's going to be your lead jammer.
Kiki's still pushing at the front.
And that's Slapjack, again, dictating where that Tent City Terrace jammer is going to go.
Really strong holding the front of the pack, and that's going to be a full five for Jammin' Jules.
Philip McCrevis out there, jam ref, holding up the big five in the sky. Tent City Terrace having a rough time getting their jammer through that pack. The sister combo of Slapjack and Axel Breaker, I think, are giving her a run for her money.
Misbehaved helping out there as well.
Sacred widening the gap just a little bit more. 76 points for Sacred City. Arizona standing strong at 25.
Ticking down to about 10 minutes on the first period clock. Both teams have all three of their timeouts.
And for your league's printing and promotional needs, hit up printcographics.com.
Let me give a shout out to Quality of Derby this morning. Has been staying awake all night. Jared Quinn is still watching along with three others at 5:19 a.m. local time for them.
Where are they watching from, Brad?
He doesn't say, but he's very impressed by the Derby.
Far away. I'm sure they're impressed with Daddy's Girl, lead jammer for Sacred City.
Looks like that's part of our might be part of our Australian contingent.
Number 314, the mathematician out there blocking for Sacred City. I happen to know that it's her birthday on Sunday.
All right, then.
I bet she would like to win this game for her birthday, I'm guessing.
Daddy's Girl with 5 points. Sybil War breaking the pack.
And Deej calls it, but a little bit too late. It looks like 1 point for Sacred. All 4 points picked up there by Arizona. Time is of the essence when you have that lead jammer nod, Brad. You got to know when to call it off.
So that limits the damage done by Sacred on that jam. Still a pretty big lead for Sacred after that jam. We got 82 points for them and 29 for the Tent City Terrors. Under 10 minutes on the clock. Colt 45 returning to the line for Sacred against Maria Montoya, number 2012.
Colt 45, tiny but mighty. She is out. She is your lead jammer.
Looks like Arizona short one blocker in the pack.
And it looks like
it's going to even up, though. We got a penalty for
Cash Money. Picked up her fourth minor there. She's going to sit in the box for a minute.
45 takes the opportunity, though. She's through the back. That's a full grand slam.
And she looks back and sees Maria Montoya is out of the pack. She's probably going to try and pick up a couple more points before calling it off.
With an apex jump, she gets past the entire pack and calls it. So that's going to be four more for Sacred on that pass. Well
done.
That
was pretty. I love watching apex jumps that work out.
So that's going to take the score to 91 for Sacred City. They're on track definitely to break the century mark before the end of this period. Loose Chaos has the star for Arizona Roller Derby and the four closer for Sacred City Derby Girls.
And it looks like Sacred taking a knee here. They have got a blocker advantage. It's 3-on-2 there in the pack.
And you said you couldn't do math.
I know. I can see, though. I can see.
Both jammers are out. Loose Chaos was awarded lead, and she takes advantage to call it off. There, we got a scoreless jam.
I think Forecloser was kind of staring her down a little bit. I got to say, if I was jamming against Forecloser and I got that look, I'd probably call it off, too.
They were neck and neck. They were neck and neck. And Sybil War taking the star now for Arizona, number 43 against number 209, Jammin' Jewels for Sacred City.
A lot of girls out there today wearing Rydell skates, the official skate of the WFTDA. Rydell skates, unmatched quality, unmatched performance.
Tangled up, getting into the pack. Oh, but we have a lead call, and that's going to be Jammin' Jewels.
Sacred, I'm going to guess, again, bad at math, that they have had the most lead jammer status nods given to them in this first half. It seems as such to me.
They do, but not by a lot. They have 9-5 calls for Arizona. So
gotcha. Grand slam there for number 209, Jammin' Jewels. Arizona jammer still stuck in the pack, and now she's out.
Jammin' Jewels gets through the pack before she calls it off. So that's going to collect four more for Sacred City.
Bringing total them to an even 100 points. Arizona, 29. 6 minutes left to go in this first half.
These teams have met once before, and Sacred City did win that bout as well.
Now, Brad, I got to say it. You think this game would have been a little bit different had the transfers not transferred?
It'd have been a little bit different, yes.
A little bit different.
Yes.
Although I'm sure Arizona is super psyched to be here at the Western Region Tournament. Who wouldn't be? Here on the Bay, beautiful Richmond, California, Daddy's Girl lead jammer for Sacred City.
It is Kiki jamming for Arizona. No, Kiki's blocking for Arizona.
Looks like we had a star pass.
We did have a star pass. That's why I was confused by the star pass to local Lena.
And Daddy's Girl, I don't think she knows local Lena's back there. Daddy's Girl goes to the box. I think a major track cut there on Deej. It's going to make her sit for a minute. And although Localina is not lead jammer, she picked up 5 points, and she's out here on a power jam.
Yeah, and she would have been ineligible to earn lead as the recipient of a star pass, but as it happens,
it don't matter.
Girl had already had it. But Localina now with a pants whip to take her into the front line, but runs right into Misbehaved and Axel Breaker.
That's a rough crew. And I'm hearing some ref calls. It looks like Axel Breaker had a direction of gameplay major. She's going to go sit for a minute. One thing Sacred City probably doesn't want to do right now is fill up that penalty box when the other team's power jam.
Any ankle biter there was hanging on to local Lena on her attempt to get around the outside, but now she gets pushed into the outside. The skater goes to the knee. So 5 points awarded. That's grand slam for Localina, just as Daddy's Girl makes it back in. fourth minor for number 56 for Arizona, which is D's Nuts.
Who's nuts?
D's Nuts.
And that's the jam. A little bit of a rotating penalty box there. Going to bring the score to 104, Sacred City, 43 for Arizona. 3 minutes and 30 seconds left in the first half.
So as usual, the final jam of each period does reach its natural conclusion. They don't stop a jam. Jared Quinn, yes, you are Aussies in Sydney. Glad to hear from you guys.
Hi, guys. Flush a toilet for me and watch it go the wrong way. And squeaking through the inside, Colt 45 picks up lead jammer for Sacred City.
On the push to the inside, Loose Chaos has the star for Arizona. She's still trying to get through on her initial pass.
Sacred Blocker's doing a great job of squishing the jammer to either side of the track and making her re-enter behind the whole pack. It's pretty frustrating as a jammer.
However, the violator for Arizona was just doing the same to Colt 45. However, Colt 45 has now completed that pass. All 5 points.
And it looks like the Arizona jammer is out of the pack, about a quarter lap behind Colt 45. Colt looks like she wants to score a couple more.
Pack moving into turn one, and before Colt 45 can get it called off, Loose Chaos picks up four.
It looks like Colt 45 went down and was a little dazed, didn't call it off in time. Sometimes when you take a good hit, it takes a couple seconds for you to recover enough to call off the jam.
So with just over 2 minutes on the clock, do we have a team timeout, or was that a...
It's a timeout.
It's a timeout of some sort because the clock has stopped.
Yep.
It appears to be an official timeout. All right.
Official.
With the score standing at 109 for Sacred City and 47 for Arizona. Local Lena has taken the star again for Arizona.
And I don't know. Oh, Forecloser is going to be jamming for Sacred City. Good choice. You know, I was talking about how Colt 45 looks a little bit like Bonnie Thunders earlier. Bonnie Thunders and OMG WTF of course, the Gotham Roller Girls own Five Stride Skate Shop, fivestride.com online. They're also in-store in the city that never sleeps, New York City.
We also have at this tournament one of the owners of Wicked Skatewear. B-Train is skating for the Angel City Derby Girls. Wicked Skatewear hearts their sponsored T-Leagues, Denver, Bad, Arizona, and Angel City.
Looks like we have an official review out on the track there, Brad.
So the clock is stopped with 2 minutes and 1 second on it.
Who else can we give shout-outs to?
How about Adam Wheels? Adam Wheels is a proud partner and the official wheel of the WFTDA.
They've got a booth here.
They've got an owner here as well, I believe.
Yes, they do. I believe we'll see her skating probably in the next game, if I guess correctly.
That is correct.
Yeah, coming up next, we have the second half of this Arizona Sacred City game. But after that, we have Rocky Mountain Roller Girls versus the Ole Rollers. If I do say so myself, I think there's going to be one or two people tuned in for that one.
I'm definitely curious to see the outcome of that myself. I mean, Ole has shown themselves to be very strong this season, even before their recent transfers.
Yes,
and
they
so
have.
Now they add some veteran Ole Rollers into the mix, plus Joy Collision, formerly of Charm City, and
yep.
What happens? I guess we'll find out.
Yeah, we will definitely find out, that's for sure. I'd like to thank everyone out there who's watching on WFTDA.tv, including my parents. Hi, Mom and Dad. I love you.
So the official review seems to be continuing. Official timeout is now in the 2 minute range. So let's thank a couple more sponsors. How about S1 Helmets? They make the safest and best helmets for roller derby. And you want to protect that brain box of yours.
Yeah, it's pretty important. I was just given this update. It looks like Bracket Bonanza is going on, Brad. That's where you can fill out your picks for the winners and the scores of every single WFTDA Big Five game that's happening live on WFTDA.tv. And the winners of each tournament bracket get a set of that tournament's DVDs. So, of course, every game that's here at the West Region Bay of Reckoning, and a Jammer Up board game. The grand prize winner gets a trip for two to championships in 2013. So if you want to win those awesome prizes, get in on your bracket bonanza on WFTDA.tv.
So the official review, looks like Arizona was calling for a major low block penalty to be assessed against the Sacred Jammer, and that was in fact awarded. So this is going to be a power jam for local Lena to start off what could be, but probably won't be, the last jam of the period.
Not the way we've been going.
So that ought to result in Colt 45 remaining the Sacred Jammer sitting in the penalty box.
Blocker advantage Sacred City for just a minute, but it looks like now we've got 3-3 back on the track. Cash Money, Math Mortician, and I keep forgetting her name.
Localina is through for lead. And it looks like the score at the beginning of the jam was corrected to 48 points for Arizona, and that's five more for them.
Morty out there directing the Sacred Pack.
The Pack is at a standstill there in turn two.
Annie Ankelbiter trying to block the other way. It's a little bit difficult sometimes to keep in contact with that person when you're turned around going the other way. I mean, unless you're like, you know, deranged or something.
And now Localina back into the pack in that same situation, trying to get past a clump of three Sacred blockers, and she does it. There's five more. Now Colt 45 is out of the Hooskow and through the pack, clear to score.
I didn't see what Morty is sitting in the box for, but she's there for a minute.
Localina calling it off from within the pack. Any more points? Yes, a full five more points for Arizona. So this has been a huge 20-point jam for the Tent City Terrors.
It looks still like 41 points, right? 41-point game? How's my math?
Correct, 41-point gap between the two.
Got to be right sooner or later.
Now, there are only a few seconds left on the period clock, so it's possible that they will not run another jam. If there are fewer than 30 seconds, they won't, but I didn't notice when they first lined up.
Yep. It looks like we're going to have one more jam.
All righty.
Four closer jamming for Sacred City.
And loose chaos for Arizona.
Loose chaos going to pick up that lead jammer nod. Forecloser juking around the outside, just about a half a lap behind Loose Chaos.
Period clock has expired. This will be the last jam of the period.
And with Sacred blockers, wow, a little bit spread out. They managed to get together right there at the end. Loose Chaos is going to pick up all 4 points.
That was a 4-4 jam, so no difference in the point gap. We closed the period with 113 points for the Sacred City Derby Girls and 72 points for Arizona Roller Derby.
That's going to bring us right into the halftime. Stick around. I have a feeling there's going to be some talking-tos happening at halftime.
Well, we've got about 15 minutes, and we'll be back a couple minutes before the second half starts. Meanwhile, just a little bit of an analysis from the first period. Clearly, the point dominance comes from Sacred City with the 41-point lead. However, a late surge here by Arizona has closed that score gap. So the lead jammer calls roughly evenly distributed between the two teams. I think it's going to come down to who can keep their head in the game the best.
I think so too, Brad. And I feel like I kind of always say this, but it's true. Whichever team is going to stay out of the box, I think, is probably going to dictate the winner of this game. Sacred City, you know, has got a 30-something point lead, but, you know, that can easily be just that can vanish.
We saw that
if they go to the penalty box.
We saw that in the first game where Wasatch came back and for six jams held Angel City scoreless.
Yep.
And so it's far too early to write Arizona off.
Definitely.
However, they are really going to have to buckle down in that second half if they want to bring it back.
Yep. You have PDA. My name is Miss Moxie.
And
this
I'm Brad Example.
Is Brad Example. We're the dynamic duo that is bringing you Arizona Roller Derby versus the Sacred City Derby Girls. I don't remember the score at halftime, Brad. I'm sure you have it there.
We're looking at a 41-point lead by Sacred City. They have 113 points versus 72 points for the Arizona Roller Derby Tent City Terrors.
All right, so about 41 point game. Not an insurmountable lead.
No.
But Sacred does have a 41-point lead. So I'm guessing that they're probably going to want to hang on to that and maybe even stretch that lead. And something tells me that the Tent City Terrors are going to come back here in the second half and, you know, want to smallinate that lead. They want to shrink it.
All right. Is that the opposite of embiggen?
Yes, it's the opposite of embiggen.
Okay.
Smallinate and embiggen.
A couple of tidbits we've learned here. First of all, Arizona Roller Derby told us using the Talk 2 WFTDA tag that AZRD practices in a non-air-conditioned warehouse in Phoenix.
Oh, my goodness.
They call it the hot house.
The
hot
house.
And you can see why.
Well, you know, it's toasty here, Brad, but it can't be nearly as hot as Phoenix in the summertime.
And as far as we did get a question of whether there was a ship going by, and at the time there was. I hope you can hear us now. But it is true that we have a microwave link for our internet here that goes across the bay, and when a great big heap of metal called a ship goes wandering past, we are prone to losing our signal. So we hope that doesn't happen, but we have no control over when it does.
Internet us, interrupt us.
Precisely.
Yeah, you know, I don't even understand how that works. So I just appreciate the fact that everybody out there in WFTDA.TV Landia can hear us and even sometimes see us.
Mm-hmm. So, yeah, this is bout number two of the day. The first one, Wasatch Roller Derby, almost pulled it back and took the win over Angel City, but Angel City held on and earned a 172-162 point victory that advances them to face the Rose City Rollers later tonight.
The number one seed in this tournament.
And the winner of this game will go on to face the number two seed tonight, the Denver Roller Dolls.
Yes. It looks like we are having a little halftime equipment check there on the track. Refs, of course, making sure that everybody's got their safety gear on properly. Safety is paramount here at the WFTDA and at the Craneway Pavilion.
We are right here on the waterfront on the San Francisco Bay.
It's so pretty. Earlier you could see the whole city of San Francisco. You could see Alcatraz. It looks like it's getting a little bit foggy over there in the city, but we don't have fog here in Richmond. It is nice and sunny.
Okay, and we've got skaters on the track now. Looks like for the first jammer of the period for Arizona is going to be number 43, Sybil War, facing go-to jammer for Sacred City, number 44, the four closer.
And we've got a pack advantage here for Arizona. Four blockers for them versus just Slapjack and Axle Breaker, the dynamic duo of sisters out there for Sacred City.
Correspondingly, Arizona taking a knee to start the jam. They want their jammer to get out there more quickly. But it's Slapjack and Axle Breaker hanging on to Sybil War at the front of the pack.
And it looks like I heard a ref whistle.
It looks like Axle Breaker headed. Ooh, and a major cutting penalty for Sybil War turns this into a power jam for the forecloser.
Power jam for the forecloser. Sneaks her way around the outside, picks up lead jammer, even though she's only got one blocker on the track. Because it looks like Sacred has one blocker standing. Math Mortician now coming out of the box to join Slapjack.
And it's also Annie Anklebiter coming out to fill out a pack of three for Sacred City.
But they are letting Forecloser do all the work there, taking a little bit of that passive offense stance.
That's Messy Missy pushing Forecloser to the outfield.
She does, in fact, pick up a grand slam. Hard-fought 5 points for the forecloser.
And down to 3 blockers on the track now as Messy Missy went to the penalty box after that pass.
Nice inside clear there by Slapjack. And one more. 5 in the sky for Forecloser and Sacred City.
Sacred City clearly looking here to consolidate that lead. They do not want to let the same thing happen to them as happened earlier today, because there's 5 more for Forecloser. This has been a big jam already, 15 points so far, and a cutting penalty major for one of the Penn City Terrors.
Forecloser gives the Arizona Pivot a little shoulder check there on her way by, picking up one more grand slam. 20-point jam so far for Forecloser.
And there's a fourth minor for number 56, D's Nuts from Arizona.
First jam of the first half here. Sacred City bringing their lead to 133 points, 72 for Arizona.
That was a 20-point unopposed, unanswered jam for Sacred City.
And it looks like jamming for Sacred, we're going to have number 209, Jammin' Jules, versus number 924, Loose Chaos, for the Tent City Terrors. Jammin' Jules out real quick, lead.
That was a long jam, taking the clock down to about 27 and a half minutes. My good friend Randy Pan informs me that the most points scored for Arizona has been by local Lena, which is number 5150, whereas the top scorer so far for Sacred City has been Forecloser with 61 points.
Not surprising. She is a powerhouse, that Forecloser.
Those are unofficial numbers, by the way. So don't quote us, but that's what we think happened. We're pretty sure that's what happened.
Colt 45 jamming for Sacred City against Loco Lena for the Tent City Terrors.
That was a quicker jam that time, because only about a minute came off the period clock there.
Yeah, both jammers get out. You got a quicker jam on your hands if that lead jammer knows what's going on. Colt 45 right up the middle. Lead jammer, Sacred City. And it looks like three wall of Sacred doing a pretty good job of keeping Localina back. Now on the floor in the very back of the pack. Colt 45 picks up a grand slam for Sacred City. There's some newfound determination there on the faces of the Sacred girls.
Definitely losing no time, trying to break things out. We got an out-of-play call now for Slapjack, number 22 from Sacred City. And more whistles blowing. This is a high block.
Yeah, we've got a high block major is going to send, who's going to the box?
I don't see who's going to the box.
Maybe it was a minor. I heard a whistle. I don't know.
Localina still has not broken out of that pack, and so 5 more points for Colt 45. 10 points so far on the jam.
Neil and Weep directing traffic in the back, hanging on to Localina. That pack is spread out over, wow, just about half the track.
So far in the game, the teams are actually pretty evenly divided between amount of time spent in the penalty box. 16 minutes so far for Arizona and 18 for Sacred City.
Definitely heard a whistle on that one.
And that's number 67 for Sacred, which is to say Rose Villain head into the box. 5 more for Colt 45.
Looks like Rose Villain's in the box for a forearm.
No, actually, I think the forearm is
cash money.
For cash money, yes.
All right, so Sacred going to be starting this jam down 2 blockers.
They're racking up both the points and the penalties. So far, no points scored by Arizona this second period, whereas we've had 24 points scored by Sacred City.
Sacred, Ken, has all of the points here in the first half of the second half.
They're going to get the star to Daddy's Girl, and the star for Arizona going to Sybil War, number 43.
Whoa, big pile up there on the inside. No calls.
And lead jammer call this time to Sybil War. That's the first lead jammer call they've gotten this period.
like Daddy's Girl having a rough go of it there in the back. Grand slam for Arizona.
That's what Arizona's been looking for, putting some points on the board. Pack now moving back across the jammer line. And Daddy's Girl breaking out. Clear to score.
Not lead jammer.
Nope. The lead call belonging with Civil War, who's trying to get around Axel Breaker. She does, and she calls it.
We have a Tent City Terror blocker sitting down for her fourth minor, so they're going to start with just, I think, three blockers on the track. Couple girls out there in Antic skates. They're fancy. The makers of Antic. Gumball toe stops, heartless wheels, reckless wheels, and moto bearings. Green Monster doesn't just give you great derby products, they give you confidence.
Score standing now at 157 for Sacred City, 81 for Arizona. Just under 23 minutes on the period clock. Their go-to jammer 44, the four closer, has the star for Sacred City.
And 924, Loose Chaos jamming for the Tent City Terrors. Looks like 44 is out and lead.
But Loose Chaos has also broken the pack. So we'll see how many points Forecloser tries to get. Looks like a multiplayer blocking penalty for number 57 from Arizona. That's Missy Missy.
Forecloser picks up that fourth point and calls it off real quick. 4-0 there for the Sacred City.
We got two players out there who are a little bit in danger of hitting their 7-minute maximum in the penalty box. Looks like one for each team. Ginger Havoc for Arizona and Cash Money for Sacred City are both standing at 5 minutes.
All right. I bet you they're both hoping they can hang on. I'm guessing. Don't want to, you know, make things up. Oh, wow. Row the outside. Jammin' Jewels, lead jammer for Sacred City. Tent City Terrors there on the outside of the track. She thought she'd just go that way.
Meanwhile, it's number 2012, Maria Montoya, with the star for Arizona.
Once more around the outside, Jammin' Jewels picks up a grand slam.
Misbehaved, hanging on to Montoya and then handing her off to Axel Breaker.
I think the reason that Arizona's having a little bit of a rough time getting their jammer out there is because they've only got two blockers on the floor and Sacred with a full complement.
That's not going to help. A fourth minor now for one of the Sacred skaters, number 113, that's Annie Anklebiter.
One more grand slam for Jammin' Jewels. She takes her 5 points and calls off the jam. 10-0 on that jam for Sacred City.
Montoya had just gotten out of the penalty box when Jewels decided to call it off. So that takes us to 81 to 171. 90-point lead now for Sacred City. This is going to be pretty tough for the Tent City Terrors to overcome, but we do still have 20 minutes in the period, so.
It looks like they're going to rely on Civil War. And we have an official timeout here. After that official timeout, Civil War is going to be jamming for the Tent City Terrors, and Cole 45 is going to jam for Sacred City.
So that stops the clock with 20 minutes, 30 seconds on the period clock. Just enough time for us to thank a couple of sponsors, such as Blood and Thunder magazine. Blood and Thunder is the world's first and largest roller derby magazine. You can find them at bloodandthundermag.com.
I also want to give a shout out to Fast Girl Skates from Seattle. Fast Girl is the first full-service brick-and-mortar derby store in the world. They bring their extensive in-store experience to you online. Fast Girl knows firsthand how to make feet happy and skaters fast. FastGirlSkates.com.
So it looks like Sacred now has given their start to number 44 for a closer for this next jam. So we got number 43 versus number 44.
Okay. That looks like the official timeout is just verifying penalty minutes in the box.
All right.
They're just making sure they got all their I's dotted and their T's crossed.
They want to get it right, and who wouldn't?
Yes, and you know, I have to give it up for the referees. The officials here at the West Region playoffs is... they're phenomenal. Like, we have three amazing ref crews reffing this bout, coming from all over, and our NSOs also coming from all over. We really appreciate our officials here, whether skating or not skating. They're doing a great job, and I haven't been angry at one call. I can't believe I'm saying that. I have not. I've agreed
and
with
ladies
every
and gentlemen,
call that's
Miss Moxie from Bay Area, who has not been angry at one call. I think that makes this a red letter day in the history of the Women's Flat Track Derby Association.
I did have a lot of coffee. I don't know. That could be it.
Oh, man.
All right. We're still official timeouting.
In that case, let me sneak in one more thank you to a sponsor. In this case, Derbalife. Derbalife.com is roller derby nutrition at its finest.
I know some Derbalife users.
Excellent.
Some eaters and drinkers of Derbalife. And also, because they're out there making left turns, left turn training. Coaching by White Flight and Mercy from the Rose City Rollers that'll help make your skaters more awesome than they believe they are.
So you'll get to see the Rose City Rollers later today taking on the victorious Angel City Derby Girls from this morning. The winner of this bout, which so far looks like it would be Sacred City, will face the Denver Roller Dolls also tonight.
Four closer out, lead just right there in turn one for Sacred City. Hot on her heels.
Civil War. Yep. Forecloser considering what she wants to do, and she calls it before she even gets into the pack.
Sometimes you just have to call off the jam, Brad.
Yep.
Sometimes when you're faced with a wall of your own blockers and the other jammer is right behind you, it's probably a good idea to call it off.
So Kiki Yoraz, number 0 for Arizona, will take on Daddy's Girl, number 53 for Sacred City.
Affectionately known as Deej.
Deej.
As in DG, Daddy's Girl.
That makes sense.
Deej.
Only two sacred blockers out there against four for Arizona, so that's going to make things a little tough for Deej.
Yeah, a little bit tough. She's tippy-toeing through. She's trying to make it happen.
Kiki is pushing on the outside, and there she goes to the inside. Lead jammer is Kiki for Arizona.
She is a slippery one, that Kiki. Daddy's Girl is deciding she's going to try and push that 20 feet. She gets out. And Math Mortician did not see Kiki there on the inside. She slides right by her, picks up 4 points, and calls off the jam. 4-0 there for Arizona.
Number 60 for Arizona, whoopsie, headed to the penalty box.
Looks like Kiki was pretty excited about that 4-0 there. Colt 45 jamming for Sacred City against Loose Chaos for Arizona.
One of the blockers out there for Arizona right now, number 57, Missy. She's going to have to be a little bit careful. She is at 6 minutes in the penalty box.
Woo!
One more, and she will have fouled out of the game.
Looks like Sacred's only got two blockers on the track, and they chose to start behind the wall of three Tent City Terrors. Very interesting.
Loose Chaos out for lead. Quickly catching up to the back of the pack as Colt 45 breaks out at the front. That leaves Slapjack and Any Ankle Biter as the last line of defense at the front, and Slapjack pushes her to the outfield, drops back. Colt 45 coming up. Loose Chaos calls it off, but not before.
Yep.
Yeah, she did
like
manage to get it called off before points are awarded to Colt 45. That's taken the score to 87-1. Wait, a couple of points got in there when I wasn't looking. 87-174. 87-174.
And as we know, Brad, you jammers can score until the fourth whistle blast.
Exactly.
So I think that's why that Sacred Jammer thought maybe she could have squeaked in one or two points, but doesn't look like that was the case.
Jammin' Jules with the star for Sacred City. Sybil War, number 43 for Arizona.
And Jammer Up. You want to play the first strategy board game based on modern-day roller derby? Check them out at jammerup.com.
Randy Pan points out to me that both teams right now have a total of 22 minutes in the penalty box. So penalty-wise, these teams are pretty even, but still nearly a 90-point scoring advantage to Sacred City. They've clearly been more successful at getting their jammer through.
I have to say, they just showed a clip of the Tent City Terrors that were sitting in the penalty box. They didn't look too upset. They looked like they were having a good time, so I got to hand it to them for that. And right now, we're checking out a little bit of a ref huddle.
The clock is stopped with 17 minutes and 40 seconds in the second and final period of this game.
One more official review. Again, our officials doing everything they can to make sure that we're looking good out here, penalty-wise, points-wise, all very important things.
We're in the modern era where a lot of these things are tracked via electronics, but I understand they are still doing official penalties the old-fashioned way with pencil and paper.
Isn't that nice? They don't have to worry about boats going by and interrupting their feed.
That's probably a good thing.
All right, it looked like our official timeout was because Sacred had contested the points scored by their jammer on that last jam. They felt that she had scored 3 points before that fourth whistle, and in fact the officials say no, the call stands, she scored 0 points before that fourth whistle.
And that actually takes the scoreboard to where I thought it was at one point, 172 for Sacred City, 87 for Arizona, so... You know, I may be getting senile, but I'm not completely insane.
You're doing good, Brad. You're doing good.
So, 172 to 87. That's an 85-point gap.
17 minutes and 40 seconds on the clock. And Mr. Rock there clarifying what we already know was a points contention by Sacred, which will stand. 0 points scored by Sacred on that last jam.
Remember that you can talk to us on Twitter if you use the hashtag talk, then the numeral 2, then WFTDA. We might even reply to you.
We probably will.
There's also, I believe, WFTDA playoffs hashtag if you just want to talk with each other.
Jam and Jewel's lead jammer for Sacred City. Tent City Terrors jammer still stuck behind a wall of 4 Sacred blockers.
Civil War trying on the outside. Trying to get a little help from Sigmund Droid. Doesn't Ooh. Quite make it. Number 9 for Arizona, Ginger Wreaking Havoc, to the box.
If I remember correctly, she was one of the blockers that was in a little bit of penalty trouble. Now we have number 22 headed to the box for a major back block. That'd be Slapjack for Sacred City.
Taking advantage of her blockers who have kept Civil War in the pack. It's a grand slam for Jam and Jewels.
A natural grand slam, they call that, when the jammer is still on the track.
10 points so far for Sacred City on this jam. They're getting darn close to the 2-century mark.
That Sacred wall keeps closing down and opening just for their jammer to come through and then closing down again. Some nice defense there by
Civil War does make it through just at the end of that jam.
We've got a 100-point lead here by the number 10 seed Sacred City against number 7 seed Arizona. 16 minutes left in this second half.
Your next pair of jammers, Kiki Uraz, going back out there for Arizona, facing the 4 closer for Sacred City.
Dun, dun, dun.
Dun, dun, dun. So that takes, you mentioned Ginger Wreaking Havoc as having been in a bit of penalty trouble. This is her 6th penalty minute, so if she goes to the box again, she will have fouled out of the game.
Now we've got a major track cut on Kiki Uraz. She's going to sit for the box, making this a power jam for Sacred City.
And the forecloser picks up lead as well, so that's a complete control of the jam.
A double whammy.
Their blockers move over to the side while Arizona tries to put up a 4 wall to hang on to forecloser in turn 1.
A whole lot of 4s.
There she goes.
Forecloser again, very strong, very agile, and a smart jammer to boot.
Probably saw some minor out of play calls being assessed.
Minor. And one more grand slam for forecloser.
So that's 10 points on the jam so far for Sacred City. And now it's number 142, the Violator, headed to the box for Arizona. They're down to 3 blockers on the track.
And it looks like we have a 4th minor there for the Sacred Pivot. She's going to go to the box.
Forecloser picks up a few more points, 5 to be precise, and calls it off. That was misbehaved. The Sacred Pivot headed to the box. So that does take Sacred City past the two-century mark, 202 to 87 for Arizona, with under 15 minutes left in the second half.
We're going to have Loose Chaos jamming for the Tent City Terrors and Colt 45, two tiny but mighty jammers.
A knee start for Arizona. They do have only three blockers to four. No, it is three.
Three on three.
Three on three in the pack. Scrum heading into turn two. Oh, on the inside. It looks like Loose Chaos breaks free for lead, but Colt 45 not far behind.
Nice squeaking through there.
And Colt 45 is catching up to Loose as they go across the jammer line.
Now, if I were the Tent City Terrors jammer, and I was that close to the opposing jammer, I would probably want to call it off and not burn the clock with any more time in the lead, because you want all the jams you can get when you're not in the lead.
As it is, she chose to keep skating, but did call it off before either jammer picked up any points, so that was a scoreless jam. We stand at 87 to 202, down to 13 minutes now.
And there's Daddy's Girl again. She's taking the star for Sacred City against Kiki Your Ass. They were having a little jammer-on-jammer chat there on the line.
Remember, you can talk to us with the hashtag WTalk number 2 WFTDA.
Kiki Your Ass out, lead jammer. Daddy's Girl just about a half lap behind her and closing fast.
Thanks to Iron Doll Clothing, lifting and separating since 2009, sponsoring WFTDA.TV.
0-0 jam there.
So now the score has been stuck at 87 to 202 for three jams in a row.
Ladies and gentlemen, don't adjust your TVs. There's nothing wrong with the score. No one's scoring any points is the issue.
Derbyology at www.derbyology.com are purveyors of the Derby Unusual. We're not crazy. We just like Derby.
Derby Unusual.
Some folks think that crazy is synonymous with liking Derby. But
yeah, that's what I was going to say. There's something a little wrong with all of us.
So Loose Chaos taking the star again after only one jam away, gets through for lead. Jam and Jules out there with the star for Sacred.
And we have a Tent City Terror sitting for a major track cut.
That's Book 'em Betty, number 5. Looks like 3 points on that pass for Loose Chaos. She had a no pass, no penalty. Legally passing one of her opponents, but she was out of bounds, so no credit for it.
Jammin' Jules is having a rough go there with a wall of three Tent City Terrors. Slapjack trying to get in there and help her out in the meantime.
Loose Chaos coming around on the inside. Full grand slam.
And it looks like a major track cut there for Jammin' Jules. Looks like she's getting a little bit tired and just couldn't be bothered to come in behind that blocker that hit her out, so she's going to serve a minute for that.
That's just the kind of advantage that Arizona needs to try and close this score a bit. They've managed to take the score now to 99 points for Arizona with four on that pass.
Arizona with three blockers on the track, with four on the track for Sacred, and that's going to be a major back block.
Ooh.
For the Tent City Terrors jammer, which is going to give us Jammin' Jules back on the track for Sacred City. I don't know how excited she is about being out there.
She's looking a little sluggish out there.
But she's out there nonetheless. It is hard work. These Tent City Terrors are serious business.
And that's going to be 5 points for Jammin' Jules, getting the job done. We have done the jammer hokey pokey.
And with just under 10 minutes left in this bout, we have got a score of 207 Sacred City, 102 for Arizona. And there you're seeing Jammin' Jules, her coach giving her some love, saying good work out there. Why don't you sit for a minute? Why don't you hang out and breathe and maybe drink some water?
9.5 minutes on the period clock, and I want to thank my home league, the Denver Roller Dolls, for giving a little shout-out using the Talk to WFTDA hashtag. We look forward to seeing the Denver Roller Dolls All-Stars taking on the winner of this game later tonight.
With a pretty spin move there on the outside, the forecloser is going to take on the Tent City Terrors and pick up lead jammer.
Jamming for Arizona. She's on the far side of the track. Can't. But that's loose chaos. Really coming back in from the penalty box, but now going out for a fourth minor.
Yeah, that's rough. That's rough luck.
Looks like a minor cut there.
And one more grand slam there for the forecloser.
But also another fourth minor for an Arizona skater. This time it's number 2012, which is Marina Montoya, heading to the box to sit next to her jammer.
And math mortician for Sacred also having a seat, making it 3-on-3 there in the pack. Forecloser kind of just handling things all by herself out there. Again, Sacred with the passive offense here.
So with 8 minutes left on the period clock, Sacred really working down to lock down this game, extending the lead now to 120 points.
Forecloser really likes that spin around the outside move. Again, she is well-versed in figure skating, so she's comfortable going backwards and forwards and every which way.
Yeah, I've known successful derby skaters with figure skating backgrounds and speed skating backgrounds and even ice hockey backgrounds.
And grand slam backgrounds.
There's a grand slam for the forecloser. That's right in the foreground there, I think.
Yes, you're right, the foreground.
All right. So that's going to take the score to 227 to 102 in favor of Sacred City, and a team timeout being called by Arizona. That's actually the first team timeout of the game.
They were being patient and waiting.
Stops the clock with 7 minutes and 15 seconds.
I'm going to give a shout out to 2-in-1 Skate Shop. Check out the Bracket Bonanza sponsor. 2-in-1 Skate Shop. Take 10% off your entire order at 2in1skateshop.com when you use the coupon code BONANZA during checkout. 2-in-1 Skate Shop. Shock the competition. And as I was saying earlier, the Bracket Bonanza is available. It's a game available on WFTDA.tv. You can go and fill out your brackets, who you think is going to win, who you think is going to lose, and what the point difference is going to be. And there are prizes for the winners of each tournament, and there's a grand prize of a trip for two to next year's championships. We don't know where that's going to be yet, but it's going to happen. So get your bracket bonanza on. Get bonanza-fied.
We want to thank those of you who are using the Talk to WFTDA hashtag, and we have seen the report that the right channel is buzzing on loud words. We're going to have our top people look into it. Top people. A little shimmying on the jammer line there between Colt 45 and Kiki Yoraz.
Colt 45 is not impressed. She is working to go up the inside, getting shut down by a wall of Tent City Terrors.
Whole group of Arizona skaters right there at the front. They have a full pack of four, and that gives the chance for Kiki to get out his lead.
Colt 45 not able to push through that wall yet. She is being scored on.
But Kiki has a wall of her own to contend with, consisting mostly of Slapjack, but also Kneel and Weep. In fact, 5 points there for Arizona.
And it looks like we have a direction of gameplay there. Going to Slapjack from Sacred City. She's going to have a seat for a minute, leaving just two blockers on the floor for Sacred. The Math Mortician and Kneel and Weep trying their best to help Colt 45 get through that pack and stop the bleeding, as it were.
But 10 points so far on this jam for Kiki Yoraz. and a big wall of skaters there in between turns 3 and 4. A major cut for Key, for that's for Colt 45. It's a power jam now, as well as a lead jammer.
And once again,
for Kiki.
When you get tired, you commit penalties. That's why we practice endurance. But I have to say, watching this game go down and watching all of the crazy intense hits, I don't know that I would be out there doing anything different. So it looks like we're going to end there with that power jam for the Tent City Terrors. And if I'm correct, we're going to start this next jam as a power jam for the Tent City Terrors, because Colt 45 just sat down.
And in fact, the jammer start handed to number 2012, Maria Montoya for Arizona. Clock ticking down to 5 minutes.
Sacred still has a 115-point lead. And we've got an official timeout on the track.
That stops the clock at 4 minutes and 59 seconds.
So I know we keep talking about WFTDA.tv, but if you want us to talk about you on WFTDA.tv, you can talk directly to thousands of Derby fans. Advertise on WFTDA.tv. Affordable packages are available for your business, boot camp, or tournament advertising. Visit WFTDA.com/sponsor opportunities to learn more.
So the officials adjusted the clock there to put 5 minutes and 1 second on the clock.
Gotta have that 1 second.
And out for lead jammer, we do have Maria Montoya for Arizona. Montoya has jammed, this is only the second time in this period that Montoya has had the star. I've seen her out there blocking quite a bit, though.
Yeah, she did jam a lot in the first half, it seemed like, and then they reserved her as a blocker in the second half.
And there goes Dee's Nuts to the penalty box for Arizona. Still have a full four blockers out there for Sacred City, giving Montoya a hard time. She's pushed to the infield, comes back in.
Pushed to the out. And that's going to get Colt 45 out of the box, not lead jammer. Woo!
Calling it off with 5 points is Montoya.
I have to say, that was a nice power jam kill there by Sacred City. Only 5 points scored on you in a power jam is a good power jam, I say. We've got exactly 110-point lead here by Sacred City. 3 minutes and 45 seconds left to go in this bout. And that is Daddy's Girl lining up against number 924, Loose Chaos, for the Tent City Terrors.
Shout out to Erica Is Busy on Twitter. Thanks for tuning in to WFTDA.TV. She's actually listening on her phone. And good to know that the audio stream is working on phones.
I really like that audio stream. It's awesome. I mean, you know, it's not anything like the video stream, but it's kind of old-timey. You know, you can listen like when you're in the bathtub or while you're mowing your lawn.
Come with us now to the thrilling days of yesteryear.
Daddy's Girl sneaking up the outside. And do we have a lead jammer? We do. Well,
Loco Lina has the star now for Arizona. It looks like there was a star pass.
And it looked like the jam ref took a little while to tell Daddy's Girl that she was lead, but she did, in fact, call it off before any points were scored. So that score is going to stand 227 Sacred City, 117 Arizona.
Ticking past the three-minute mark, the Sacred City Derby girls are going to give the star to... Oh, we got a timeout called by Arizona. That's the second of their three timeouts, stopping the clock at just a hair under 3 minutes. And Jammin' Jules was out there with the star for Sacred City. And Loose Chaos
for the Tent City Terrors.
For the Tent City Terrors, retrieving the star from Localina, to whom she had passed it in the previous jam.
You take it. No, I'll take it. No, you take it.
Give
no,
me
no,
that.
I don't want it. I don't want it. You take it. www.derbyforall.com. Experienced derby skaters getting you the right gear to take you to the next level. Mounting plates until Sunday morning at their mega booth. I believe they are here.
And that's www.derby4all.com.
And even though this is only the second game of the day, I have to say the Craneway Pavilion looks pretty darn packed. And we definitely have some fans in the crowd that have some things to say.
We got bleachers all around the track. They're pretty full of folks. In case you hadn't noticed, the three-day passes for this tournament actually did sell out. And so now you have to come and try and get day-by-day passes. Shout out to Cosmic on Twitter, who's watching, quote-unquote, watching Besterns on the big screen. Glad to hear that you're enjoying the tournament and the commentary. And Violent Bob can't help but wonder how this game could have gone. And that's all I'm going to say about that. Loose Chaos out of the pack. Lead Jammer for Arizona.
Jammin' Jewel is about a quarter lap behind her. And closing.
Loose Chaos through the pack has points, apparently trusting to her blockers to hang on to Jammin' Jewels, but Jammin' Jewels is now pushed to the outside. And it's a track cut for Jammin' Jewels, so that gamble pays off as we have a power jam for Loose Chaos.
Loose Chaos does not look tired. She has been out there jamming like every third, and she still looks like she could play another game right after this, which is good because, oh, that's going to be a major. Yeah, I believe that was a misconduct.
We're seeing the teapot of misconduct from her jammer ref.
You can't make contact with both your skates off the ground, and that, in fact, is what she did while she was.
And it's adding an illegal procedure, so that's going to be 2 minutes in the box for Loose Chaos. A very, very unfortunate jammer penalty towards the end of this bout. In fact, that should keep her in the penalty box pretty much through the end of the game.
Yep.
Jammin' Jewels back on the track facing a three wall of Arizona blockers. She has a full set of blockers herself, but they are executing the passive offense right now.
Yeah, and you know, all Sacred really has to do at this point is just wait. I mean, we've got a 100-point game here and 1 minute left to play. Don't think that Arizona is going to pull that out. It'd be incredible, but I don't see it happening.
That would be one for the ages if they managed to score 100 points in 1 minute. I think it would be a measurable alteration in the spin of the earth if they pulled that one off. And it looks like that is the end of the jam. Is it going to be the end of the game? No, because there's more than 30 seconds on the period clock.
Yep, we're going to have one more jam, and Sacred is going to field the four closer. They've got a full complement of blockers there out there for Sacred. Three blockers for the 10th City Terrors. And the four closer looks like she's directing traffic. She's giving her blockers some hand signals.
We're going to give a shout out to Canberra Roller Derby League in Australia. They're up early to watch Westerns. So hello to Penergy out there in Canberra.
Hi, Penergy. Hi, Forecloser, Lead Jammer, Sacred City.
Time has expired on the period clock, so when the jam is over, the game is over.
And it looks like the jammer for the 10th City Terrors is standing.
Yep, Loose Chaos back on the track for Arizona. Grand slam for Forecloser. Loose Chaos does still have to get through the pack to be able to score. But Loose Chaos now through the pack and cleared a score.
So Loose Chaos apparently went to the box not only for that illegal or the misconduct for making conduct in the air, but also for removing her mouth guard. Illegal procedure.
That's the illegal procedure that they
did. Yeah, you can't take your mouth guard out until you sit in the penalty box. So it looks like that's going to bring us to the close of this game. I believe we have a final score.
Well, we'll wait for it to be official, but it's pretty clear at this point that the Sacred City Derby girls have won the game and will advance to face the Denver Roller Dolls Mile High Club tonight.
Hi, I'm Joe Mama, joined by Evil Shenanigans from the Sacred City Sacrificers. Congratulations on your victory, Arizona. A hard-fought bout, but a decisive win for you guys.
It was actually a very hard bout. They've really been preparing for this, and they came out of the gate hitting. And as it was obvious in the first half, they made up a huge point deficit. They really capitalized on power jams. But at the same time, we were able to capitalize on our power jams.
I have to hand it to your jammers. They're very powerful and also very smart. The way they approach those walls that Arizona had set up was very, very smart, very slow, very deliberate.
Yes. Being in the pack with them, you can see that as they're going through, they actually are looking through the entire thing to see where the wall is. And so they make very, very conscious decisions when they're going through. We've really focused on making sure that people are making the smart calls, not the quick calls.
Right. All right, now that you're warmed up, all right, we have another bout upcoming.
We do.
6 p.m. against the Denver Roller Dolls Mile High Club. Sacred City's faced off against them 3 times. Only 2 were sanctioned.
Correct.
What have you guys done to prepare for Denver?
What we've done is we've taken those 2 times that we've played against them and figured out where our strong points are and then where our weaknesses are. And so we've really been working on becoming more of a cohesive unit out on the floor to stick together. Denver has extremely hard hitters. They can break up a pack pretty quickly. So we're trying to make sure that they can't break us up.
All right, well, good luck, and congratulations on playing above your seed.
Thank you. We came in at number 10.
Good luck at 6 o'clock. Thank you.
Thank you.